Work is underway on what will be New Zealand's first new town, a community planned in detail before the first sod is turned.
Drury, south of Auckland, is the location for the development, which will end up being larger than Napier. So what do the locals think about becoming a city, and more importantly, who will be mayor? Here's Mary Jane Aggett.
Here we go, here's Drury.
It's hugging the motorway 40 minutes south of Auckland on a good day.
So I'm looking for your city.
Yeah, I don't know where it is. I've been here for, since the mid-70s and can't find it either.
Anthony Wright's grown up around these parts and is surprised by the multi-million dollar development plan.
I'm in denial, you know. I love this place, nice and quiet and sleepy. It's crazy.
They're going to need a mayor.
Yeah, well, I suppose I can put my hand up.
And with that, the tour begins. Anthony, the tyre man, showing us the sights.
This was the main drag of Drury, you know. It's crazy that the horses and carts used to come down here. This is the Drury Harbour Bridge. It's a one-lane harbour bridge. And, you know, I hate to think what's going to happen when they bring a city. So if you vote for me as mayor, I'll make sure that we get to keep this icon.
But progress is coming, and so is the new mall in these paddocks.
Well, you know, apparently it's just going to be a dream city. It's going to be like Sylvia Park on steroids.
Sylvia Park, that's the big flash mall up the road. And Anthony's keen to point out that Drury already has shops.
Well, you've got the bakery right there. You know, it's a good bakery. And we've actually got two. We've got another bakery up there as well.
And a butcher. Here's John.
There's a lot of new people coming to Drury, a lot of families. We're seeing a big, massive change in our customer base in this store over the last 6 or 7 years.
Deputy Mayor?
Deputy Mayor, I'll take that, yeah. Yeah, I might have trouble getting some change around. My neck's quite big, so that'll be, we'll see what happens.
And Brent Catchpole, chairperson of the Papakura local board, joins us now. Brent, why is Drury changing?
Well, there's a big development happening here. Big announcements today about the huge developments that are going to come here over the next 30 years with something like 20,000 homes and probably double that in the number of people.
Brent, how good is this going to be for your area?
Oh, look, we see this as a golden opportunity for the development of the whole area, including the metropolitan centre of Papakura, which the local board has spent some time in developing a plan for, and I've got it here if anybody wants to have a look at it. But we see it as a great opportunity for the future.
Brent, is there any concern that this might change the culture of Drury? Because it's obviously a special place.
It is a special place. It's a small country town at the moment. But we're going to be overrun by a large increase in population, so we've got to be ready for it and be embrace it and make sure that we make the most of it.
Are you considering a name change? Because Drury does sound a lot like Dreary.
Never. No, it's not Drury at all. It is a lively little township, and we would challenge that being called Drury. It's definitely not Drury. It's a great little township, got a great little community, and it's going to be a much bigger community in the future. It's got a lot of history, and it's got a lot of future.
Maybe the catchphrase could be Drury. It's not Drury.
No, we wouldn't go there.
He doesn't like it.
Be more positive. Be more positive.
That is positive.
Come on, Jeremy.
It's a lot more positive than Hamilton, more than you'd expect.
Oh, no. Come on. Drury is a lovely place. And if you have a look around Drury before you leave here, just take a look around and you'll see it's a wonderful little place.
Brent, you're a good man. Thanks so much for your time this evening.
Thank you. And you have a great weekend.
ASB and 7 Sharp. Keeping you one step ahead.
Oh, poor old Brent. What is it against Drury? You've got to stop being so mean.
I love Drury. I've got nothing against Drury.
What's your favourite thing about it?
The butcher.
Great butcher. He seemed like a good guy. And I have a more positive slogan. I just had a wee think about it. Drury, dream big. I think that's fitting.
Well, it is actually. I think
Brent would like that.
Yeah, 200,000 people.
Send him an email.
Yeah, it's not a bad one actually. I mean, let's be honest. New Zealand has had a lot of towns in New Zealand have really struggled when it comes to finding a catchphrase. I mean, as we said before, Hamilton more than you'd expect. That's not a good one because clearly they said Hamilton and people said, well, there's nothing there, and they said, well, there's more than you'd expect.
And yet, because you're saying that people expect nothing, want them to, like, some people might have expected something.
Yes, and of course there's Whanganui. Which is their old motto was, well worth the journey. So someone said, well, Whanganui's a long way out of the way. And they said, no, it's well worth the journey. And Dunedin, of course, it's all right here. It's, well, you go a bit more positive than that.
Like, it's all right here, as in, well, everything's here. Well, yeah, it's all right here.
That's right, it's the double meaning, but, you know, it's all right here.
Taranaki like no other? I thought that was quite good.
Sort of like Mount Fuji a bit, isn't it?
Well,
Mount Taranaki.
I guess it is a little like that. Yeah. That's why they didn't think that through, did they?
Yeah.